Mr Speaker, with your permission, I will make a statement on the measures we must now take to contain the autumn surge of coronavirus, protect our NHS and save lives. On Saturday evening, the Chief Medical Officer and the Chief Scientific Advisor described the remorseless advance of this second wave. The extraordinary efforts being made by millions of people across the country, especially by those in very high alert areas, have made a real difference, suppressing the R rate below where it would otherwise have been. But the R is still above one in every part of England, as it is across much of Europe, and the virus is spreading even faster than the reasonable worst-case scenario. There are already more COVID patients in some hospitals now than at the height of the first wave, 2,000 more this Sunday than last Sunday. While the prevalence of the virus is worse in parts of the north, the doubling time in the southeast and the Midlands is now faster than in the northwest. Even in the southwest, where incidence remains low, current projections mean they will start to run out of hospital capacity in a matter of weeks. And the modelling presented by our scientists suggests that without action, we could see up to twice as many deaths over the winter as we saw in the first wave. Faced with these latest figures, there is no alternative but to take further action at a national level. I believe it was right to try every possible option to get this virus under control at a local level with strong local action and strong local leadership. And I reject any suggestion that we are somehow slower in taking measures than our European friends and partners. In fact, we're moving to national measures when the rate both of deaths and infections, for instance, is lower than they were in France. We are engaged as a country in a constant struggle to protect lives and livelihoods, and we must balance the restrictions we introduce against the long-term scars they leave, whether for businesses and jobs or our physical and mental health. No one wants to impose measures unless absolutely essential, so it made sense to focus initially on the areas where the disease was surging and not to shut businesses, pubs and restaurants in parts of the country where incidence was low. I want to thank the millions who have put up with local restrictions, sometimes for months on end. I want to thank them and the local leaders who have understood the gravity of the position. And we will continue as far as possible to adopt a pragmatic and local approach in the months ahead. But we are fighting a disease, Mr. Speaker. When the data changes course, we must change course too. And to those in this House who believe we should resist further national measures, let me spell out the medical and moral disaster we face. If we allow our health system to be overwhelmed, exactly as the data now suggests, then that would not only be a disaster for thousands of COVID patients, because their survival rates would fall, we would also reach a point where the NHS was no longer there for everyone. The sick would be turned away because there was no room in our hospitals. That sacred principle of care for anyone who needs it, whoever they are, and wherever, whenever they need it, could be broken for the first time in our lives. Doctors and nurses could be forced to choose which patients to treat, who would live, and who would die. And this existential threat to our NHS comes not from focusing too much on coronavirus, but from not focusing enough. If we fail to get coronavirus under control, it is the sheer weight of demand from COVID patients that would deprive others of the care they need. Cancer treatment, heart surgery, other life-saving procedures, all this could be put at risk if we do not get the virus under control. And even though we are so much better prepared than before, with stockpiles of PPE and ventilators, the Nightingales on standby and 13,000 more nurses than last year, I'm afraid the virus is doubling faster than we could conceivably add capacity. Even if we doubled capacity, the gain would be consumed in a single doubling of the virus. And so on Wednesday, the House will vote on regulations which, if passed, will mean that from Thursday until the 2nd of December in England, people will only be permitted to leave home for specific reasons, including for education, for work if you cannot work from home, for exercise and recreation outdoors with your household or on your own or with one person from another household or support bubble, for medical reasons, appointments, and to escape injury and harm, to shop for food and essentials, and to provide care for vulnerable people or as a volunteer.